Now we need to represent this data in such a form that our machine learning algorithm can work. Okay, so we have to do something like that. Okay, so we have something called as bag of words. So a bag of word model is simple to understand and to implement. So it is a way of extracting features from a text for use in machine learning algorithms. Okay, so let's see what is bag of word. Let's see how to convert a word or a sentence into a feature so that we can use that for a machine learning algorithm. So if I go to this open board, okay, so let's try to take few sentences. Let's try to consider few sentences. Okay, so bag of words. So let's see that what till today what we have covered. Okay, so what we have done is we have a text, or you can see unstructured data. Unstructured data, and this we have done a pre-processing part. So pre-processing part is done for us. So we know how to do a pre-processing part. So can anyone tell me step by step that in processing what involves? What are things involved in pre-processing?
Tokenization.
Tokenization. Then
removing stop words.
Stop words.
And punctuations.
Punctuations.
Lemmatization. Okay, so this is the important step in pre-processing, and it depends on use case to use case. Okay, so for example, you are extracting something from emails, and then the emails will be there. So if you want to remove that, so basically what you have to do, you have to use something called as RE, that is regular expression, to remove a particular email or stuff like this. Okay, so it depends on use case to use case. If some particular stuff is not mentioned as a function, then you have to use regular expression. So basically, you know how to clean our unstructured data. But the next step is that we have to convert this text, we have to convert this step in a numerical form. Why in numerical form? Anyone?
Our model has to be fed with.
Yeah, so that a model can be trained. So everyone knows that ML model will only work on a numerical data, because the function, that is y equal to mx plus c, the multiplication addition will happen only a numerical stuff, right? So we have to convert this into a numerical form. So basically what we have something called as bag of words. So it's a very simple technique, all the algorithm that they have followed.
Option, we saw word vectors yesterday, right? That was also similar to me.
Yeah, word vector is, but that's for the advanced level. So if you're doing NLP, in deep learning, then the word vector is very important. Okay, just for basic sentiment analysis and stuff like that. So you can use bag of words or TF-IDF. Okay. Yeah. So yes, we have basically bag of words. We have TF-IDF. And the accurate and the best one is word vectors that I have shown you yesterday. Okay, so these are the three methods. Okay, so let's see everything one by one. So let's go with bag of word first. So we have something called as bag of words, or BOW. So let's consider sentence one. Okay, so I will take sentence one. I will take sentence 2, and I will take a sentence 3. Sentence 1 is, he is a good boy. Sentence 2 is, she is a good girl. And sentence 4 is, boy and girl are good. Okay, so this is a random sentence I have taken. So after doing the pre-processing, so can anyone tell me what will be the word left for sentence 1, sentence 2, and sentence 3?
First, it will be good boy.
Okay, so first sentence, it will be a good boy. For second one,
good girl.
Okay, so second will be good girl. And for a third?
Boy, girl, good.
Boy, girl, good. This, we everyone knows that this is a cleaning of a text. Okay. Now, what we have to do is, first you have to understand that this particular thing, what you can see, sentence one, sentence two, sentence three is nothing but a row. So this is row one, this is row two, and this is row three. Okay, so in the CSV file, so each sentences will be a row. Okay, so this whole thing is called as corpus. This whole thing is corpus. So I am basically tell you terminology now. Okay, so this whole thing is called as corpus, and this corpus contains a document. So this is called as documents. Each sentence is considered as a document. So this is document one, document two, document three. So basically, someone asks you in interview, what do you mean by corpus? So corpus is nothing but a collection of documents. So this terminology is clear to everyone?
Yes.
So corpus is basically the whole data, and inside that we have a document. So basically, corpus is a collection of documents, you can say, in short. Okay. So this is a terminology that you should know. Okay. Now our text is clean. Suppose our text is clean. So what is the next step we have to do? Okay. So with the next step, what we have to do is we have to create something called as vocabulary. We have to create something called as word vocabulary. Okay. So this is nothing but go to the first sentence. So what are the two words that is present?
Good and boy.
Good and boy.
Okay. So write the same word here. Good and boy. What about second sentence?
Good girl.
Good
and girl, right? Then, but if you type good, so good is already present in the vocabulary, right? So you don't have to repeat the words. In this vocabulary, the repetition of the word will be nullified. For example, this good boy, and again is good girl, right? So when you type good, when you write good, good is already there, right? So you will not write good. What you will write is girl. So in the third sentence, can you tell me what is the word that is present?
Boy, girl, good.
So do I have to write something in vocabulary?
No.
Okay, so this is nothing but a vocabulary. And what is this vocabulary? This vocabulary, the length you can see is nothing but a features now. Okay, so what I mean to say is, in the vocabulary, you are having good, girl and boy. This is nothing but a feature that you see in machine learning. So feature in the sense?
Yes.
So suppose this is a table that you have. So in machine learning, you have something called as table, and you have something called as X and Y. X is a feature and Y is a target variable, right? So this is what we have. So, okay. So each features is a each row. What I mean to say is, now feature one is good, feature two is girl, feature three is boy. So these are the features. So feature one, feature two, feature three. So till here is clear to everyone?
Yes.
Okay. Now we have sentence one, we have sentence two, we have sentence three. So we have to basically check all the sentence now. So in the sentence one, good was present.
Yes.
So you will put one here. In sentence one, girl was present?
No.
So you'll put zero here. In sentence in boy, girl was present?
Boy was present, yes.
Boy was present. So answer is one. Yes. In sentence two, good was present?
Yes.
Girl was present?
Yes.
Boy was present?
No.
What about sentence three?
All were present.
This is what you mean by sentence to vector tokenization. Okay, so sentence one can be represented as 101. Sentence two can be represented as 110. Sentence three can be represented as 111. This is the basic concept of word vector that we have studied in the previous class. So this is what a converting a sentence into a vector form. So this part is clear to everyone?
Yes.
Okay. So the only thing what you do is now your target is achieved, right? The target was that somehow you have to convert this sentence into a numerical form. So it's converted now. The only thing what you have to do is you have a target variable, suppose. You have to just use a machine learning algorithm and train this particular CSV file or whatever you have. Okay, so this is nothing but a bag of words. So it's clear to everyone? Bag of words topic is clear to everyone?
Yep.
So anyone has a doubt, they can ask.
So just to check, the vocabulary is basically all the features which are important, which are mentioned in a corpus, right?
Exactly. So feature, so the vocabulary is nothing but a unique feature that is present in entire corpus.
Okay.
So let's try to solve one more example so that we can verify that what we're thinking is correct or not. Okay. So this is the first thing. Okay. So suppose this sentence one, that it was the best of times, it was the worst of times, it was the age of wisdom, and it was the age of foolishness. Okay. So suppose I have this. So for this small example, I will treat each line as separate document. So as I told you, that each line is called as document. So each line is called as document. And the entire thing is called as?
Corpus.
Corpus. Okay. So just remember this terminology. Let's clear this. So what is the next step we have to do? Suppose we have not, for now, suppose we have not cleaned the data. Okay. Suppose we have not cleaned the data, we are directly going to the vocabulary part. Okay. So in the vocabulary, let's start with one by one. So it not present, let's put it. Was not present, let's put was. The not present, let's put the, let put the, then best of times. Yes, then it, so do I have to write it in vocabulary?
No.
Was?
No.
The?
No.
Worst?
Yes.
I have to have worst also. Of?
No.
Times?
No.
No, right? In the third sentence also, this will be not be written. H? Yes.
Yes.
Of? No.
Wisdom.
And wisdom? Yes. In the last one, I have had only foolishness, if I'm not wrong, right? So this is nothing but a vocabulary. So basically, this is nothing but what? For in a tabular form, if we convert this, so what is this behind the scene?
Features.
It is a features. Okay. So let's try to see the PPT. So here on, let's try to see the PPT now. So basically, we are creating a vocabulary. So we treat each sentence as a separate document, and we'll make a list of all the words from all the four documents, excluding the punctuation. So here we are excluding the punctuation. Okay. So it was the best of times, worst age, wisdom, and foolishness. Okay. This is nothing but a vocabulary that you have created. The next thing what you have to do is we take the first document. It was the best of times, and we check the frequency of word from the 10 unique words. Basically, this is what you get. Okay. So it was present in the first one. So one, yes. Was present. One, yes. The was present. One, yes. Best, yes. Of, yes. Time, yes. Worst, no. Age, no. Wisdom, no. Foolishness, no. Okay. So if I run this, so this will be the conversion of a particular sentence to a vector form for all the sentences. So rest of the documents will look something like this. So this is clear to everyone.
Yes.
Okay. So this is how we convert a particular text into a vector form. Again, I'm saying that this is a basic method. Then a complex method we have is, we have something called as TF-IDF. And then more complex we have is something called as word to vec. Okay. So this is the basic one that we are covering now. Then afterwards we cover the TF-IDF. So, yes.
If we are doing this for a classification, and each sentence will have an associated label also, right?
Yes. So in this, suppose you have associate label, it was the best of time, so it's a positive sentence. It was the worst of a negative sentence. It was the age of positive, negative. So yes, you will have a label for that. Yes.
Okay.
So the process of converting NLP text into numbers is called as vectorization. Okay, so if someone asks in NLP that what do you mean by vectorization, so this answer you have to give. The process of converting NLP text into a numbers is called vectorization. Okay, so this is the definition you have to give. The result, so can you tell me that if I don't remove the stop words, if I don't remove the stop words, so what is happening here?
Too many features.
Too many features and too many zeros also, right? Too many features and too many zeros also. So the result in a vector with lots of zeros scores called a sparse vector, okay, or sparse representation. So if someone is saying that you have a sparse matrix, that means that your matrix has a lot of zeros. Okay, so this is a term that you can also remember. So I will just highlight this term. Okay, this is a very important term in a NLP world. Okay, so sparse vector or a sparse representation. So when someone says, what do you mean by sparse vector or sparse representation? If your vector or if a representation contains a lot of zeros, okay, so it is called as sparse vector and sparse representation. So can anyone tell me what is the disadvantage of sparse vector or sparse representation or a sparse matrix, you can say?
Overfitting.
Okay, then
it would contain less information compared to the other.
Basically the main disadvantage of sparse vectors are that sparse vectors requires more memory and computational resources when modeling, and the vast number of position or dimensions can make the modeling process very challenging and stuff like this. Okay, so I will explain you. So sparse is a lot of zeros, right? So you understand this that zero also takes place in memory. Yes.
Yeah.
So what happens is, if you are multiplying two matrices, so basically what is happening when you multiply two matrices, so zero into something is what? Zero, right? So when you have a gradient descent like this, so when it tries to learn something, then again it is multiplied by zero, and then again it reaches to the original place. Then again it tries to reach somewhere, but again somewhere we have zero. Then again it tries to get multiplied by zero, and again so answer becomes zero, then again tries to get to the original position. So are you understanding what I'm trying to say? So for example, if I have I mx plus c, now suppose this m we have reached to some position, but again this x again is coming as zero. So m into zero into c is what? Again zero, right? Then zero minus the loss will be what? The loss itself. So basically again my model is not learning something, or it will take a time to learn. Are you getting what I'm saying, everyone?
Yeah.
So this is a problem of sparse matrix. So your job is to reduce as much as possible the sparse matrix thing. Okay, so the simple solution is cleaning of the data. So simple solution is cleaning of the data. And how to clean the data? So as such, there's a pressure to decrease the size of the vocabulary when using a bag of words. So basically, if you don't remove the bag, or if you don't remove the stop words or punctuation, basically your vocabulary will increase. So your computational increases and the sparse matrix increases. So together, these both will cause a lot of problem. So our job is to minimize this as much as possible. So we have something called as cleaning of data. So that's why we remove stop words and punctuation. Now it's clear to everyone that why we remove stop and we don't consider stop words and punctuation in a text. Why we remove that?
Yeah.
So whatever we have done in all the four libraries, they've seen that okay, we clean the data. But why we clean the data? Now point is clear to everyone.
Yes.
Okay. Basically, we have to decrease the matrix or the word vector that is created, and we have to eliminate the process of sparse matrix. That's it. Okay, that's why we have something called as cleaning of the data. Now look here. If I clean, I'm taking the same example. Okay, and if I'm cleaning the data. So this is what I get, right? Best times, worst times, age, wisdom, and age foolishness. So basically, how many vocabulary do I have now? One is best, worst, age, wisdom, and foolishness. So basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes?
Times as well, right?
Yeah, times. No, times is considered this here. Okay, so best, times, 2, 3. Okay, then 4, 5, and 6. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so basically this we have 6. If we don't clean the data, we have how much? We have this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So when you clean the data, the features gets reduced from 10 to 6. So this is the advantage of using, this is what you mean by cleaning of data. It's clear to everyone?
Yep.
Okay, so what we have seen till now is we have a text data. We do a pre-processing. And we try to convert this into a numerical form using a method bag of words. Okay, and then once this is converted to a tabular form, then you can apply any machine learning algorithm of your choice. Okay, so based on it, whether it's a structured data or unstructured data, so structure means that you have a target variable, unstructured that you don't have a target variable. So based on that, you can just apply the ML algorithm and you can get the prediction. Now the whole step is clear to everyone that how prediction happens in NLP. Anyone has a doubt, they can ask me. In a chat box, just type yes or no if everything is clear. Okay, so yes, okay, great. Now this is what we call as bag of words. Okay, so what we'll do is when I will do the use cases, so we'll apply both bag of words and TF-IDF, and we try to see that what is the difference between, or how much accuracy we are getting between these two algorithms. Okay, so bag of words and TF-IDF. So bag, I think. Yes.
Yeah. In this bag of words, if word is like common, then it will give more weightage to that word, right? Example, times was appearing more.
So you are saying that yeah. if this was good times. So suppose two times it will be two times.
No, right? Example, I'm saying good boy, right? So yeah, we are giving more weightage to good word because good is in all sentences. Then model will not go to overfitting. Like if your common word is repeating more times.
So let me try to go to this table then. Okay. So it depends on use case to use case. What if my job was not to, suppose my use case for this particular thing was to identify whether the sentence was speaking for a girl or a boy. Okay, my use case was that.
Okay.
Whether this particular sentence was for a boy or for a girl or for both, for example, okay? So there are good matters now?
No,
right? What matters? Girl and boy matters. So my machine learning model will learn that whenever the boy is one, then that particular sentence is boy. When boy is zero and girl is one, that particular sentence is for girl. Yes or no?
Right.
So this good word is not given a weightage. So this is how ML algorithm will learn behind the scene when you give more amount of data. If the use case is that I have to tell whether the sentence is if the sentence is for a positive or negative sentence, then you have to give more data where for the positive sentence, good will having one and bad will be having zero and vice versa. Now you're getting my point?
Yeah.
So it depends on use case to use case. So in this use case, my main agenda was to show you how bag of words works. Okay. So this is not a proper use case. But if I convert this into a proper use case, now it makes sense, right?
Yeah.
Now good word, if let it be 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, no. But my use case is whether the sentence is speaking for a boy or a girl. Now what matters? This feature and this feature matters a lot, right?
Yeah.
So this is how ML works behind the scene. Now it's clear. I hope now I hope it's clear to you.
Yeah.